إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله تبارك وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهديه الله فلا ضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، أما بعد فيقول الحمد سبحانه: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم أما بعد، my beloved brothers and sisters, I would like to remind you with its day, the day of Yawm al-Jum'ah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins and gather us in Jannat al-Firdaws al-A'la with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we sit in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to worship Him only alone for Salat al-Jum'ah, Yawm al-Jum'ah. After saying that, for the last khutbah, we talk about the good deeds, al-amal al-salih, and we explain to the brothers, the sisters, to the ibadillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala, how al-amal al-salih will raise the Muslim to a level that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala He loves. After saying that quick, we come today to the next topic, will be about Al-Khawf wa-Raja. The Muslim, as he worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he has the fear, the khawf from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in dunya and akhirah, he should also have a hope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He forgives if we do something wrong. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث الذي رواه أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه، and this hadith, hadith Qudsi, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, la, قال الله سبحانه وتعالى وعزتي وجلالي لا أجمع بيني وبين عبدي خوفين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He swear by His Qudra, by His Jalal, He's saying, I will not carry in the heart of my slave in day of judgment two khawf, two fears, and two hope. If he fears me in dunya, I will secure him in the akhirah. And if he didn't fear me in the dunya, I will not secure him in the akhirah. Means the Muslim has to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّمَا ذَلِكُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ يُخَوِّفُ أَوْلِيَاءَ فَلَا تَخَافُوهُمْ وَخَافُونِي إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, verily, the shaytan is gonna make his follower to fear him only. Means the shaytan will make you always fear of things. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's saying in the Quran, in the ayat of the Quran, do not fear no one except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if you have the true iman. Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad used to say, rahimahullah, من خاف الله دله الله على كل خير. Who fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will lead him to the khair of this dunya and khair of the akhirah. Because for real, for sure, if the Muslim always fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not to do anything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he forbid. Of course, in the other way, you will look for the right thing to do that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will reward you, he will love you if you do it. Al-Hasan ibn Basri, Al-Hasan al-Basri used to say to Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu, when we sit together and we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we remember or we mention Yawm al-Qiyamah, we feel the khawf until we reach our heart, it will fly as fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then this great Imam Al-Hasan Al-Basri said, verily, if you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now, this is the most secure for the Muslim in the Akhirah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned earlier in the first hadith, I mentioned the hadith which is Qudsi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said, وكذلك أخذ ربك إذا أخذ القرى وهي ظالمة. Verily, this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he takes the قرى, the nations, the people, the villages, the towns, when they have the ظلم on themselves, on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Means, when they start leaving the shar' of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do things other than what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger came with. وَكَذَلِكَ أَخْذُ رَبُّ إِذَا أَخَذَ الْقُرَى وَهِيَ ظَالِمَةٌ إِنَّ أَخْذَهُ أَلِيمٌ شَدِيدٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is describing his أخذ, his أخذ, his punishment as it's gonna be severe. After saying that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ شَقُوا فَفِي النَّارِ لَهُمْ فِيهَا زَفِيرٌ وَشَهِيقٌ. Those ashqiya, those ones who left the shar of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he prepared for them a punishment in the fire, because the Muslim, the only way that he will leave the shara' of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ahkam of his deen, when he has no iman, when he has no fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he raised the muttaqeen, the mu'mineen. Qala subhanahu wa ta'ala, walamma sakata an Musa al-ghadabu akhadha al-alwaha wa fi nuskhatiha hudan wa rahma. لِلَّذِينَ هُمْ لِرَبِّهِمْ يَرْهَبُونَ. This alwah, this book, this Torah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send it to Musa alayhi salam. What it has? هُدًا وَرَحْمَةً. Guidance, mercy, forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For who? لِلَّذِينَ هُمْ لِرَبِّهِمْ يَرْهَبُونَ. This who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, those who have the khashya, al-muraqabah lillah, al-khashya lillah, al-khawf min Allah, those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah said, innama yakhsha Allah min ibadihi al-ulama. Al-ulama. It doesn't mean the scholars here. People always repeat this ayah. Said, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاء الْعُلَمَاء. No, it means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will have the khashya on the mu'mineen who have the ilm about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Allah said in Quran, فَعْلَمْ فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. No, there is no one to worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكَ. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the forgiveness for your sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, إن الله إن الذين يخشون ربهم بالغيب لهم مغفرة وأجر كبير. Those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only because they hear, they know some words, some ahadith, some Quran, but they didn't see any punishment yet. We didn't see Yawm al-Qiyamah yet. We didn't know what's going to be in the grave. We don't see how the fire, how Jahannam will be looks like. We don't see yet the Jannah, how it's going to be look like. But this is something Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He calls it ghaib. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ. And the most, after saying all that, we don't see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will forgive them. وَأَجْرٌ كَبِيرٌ. A great reward. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said something about the muttaqeen and muhsineen. قال سبحانه وتعالى. And this is a great news for the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For the Muslims who worry about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His house of Allah. للذين أحسنوا. There is no ihsan in akhirah. الإحسان in dunya. أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراه. الإحسان as the مفسرين explained, أن تعبد الله, you worship Allah as you see Him. But thirdly, if you don't see Allah سبحانه وتعالى, for sure He's seen you. للذين أحسنوا الحسنى. Al-Husna means Al-Jannah. For the Muhsineen, for the Mu'mineen, for those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Jannah is waiting for them. Waziyada. What else? Ziyada, like something extra. Something extra. Like, let's say, you buy 2 pounds of apple. And after he take it, the one you get it from, he will put one extra. So he will charge you for that one. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَزِيَادَ. There is something after the Jannah. As ziyada huna means to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ. So brothers, sisters, this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He prepared for those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained how Jahannam will be. قال sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hadith which is narrated by Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, قال sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, نَارُكُمْ الَّتِي تُوْقِدُونَ عَلَيْهَا هي جزء من 70 جزءا من نار جهنم. The fire we have nowadays and the fire we have it in dunya, it can burn houses, bodies, anything. The fire we have it nowadays, it can do anything. Subhanallah. How powerful it is. But wait. The Jahannam, the fire in Akhirah, is gonna be stronger than this one for 70 times. The fire, the Jahannam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He prepared it for the Usaa, for Zalimeen, for the Munafiqeen, for the Kuffar. For tariq al-salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, it's gonna be over 70 times than the fire in dunya. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us secure and safe from the punish of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the akhirah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله تبارك وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. After saying that, the khawf has levels, has categories. I will mention two. The first one will be about al-khawf min makr Allah azza wa jalla in dunya. فالله سبحانه وتعالى أفأمنوا مكر الله فلا يأمن مكر الله إلا القوم الخاسرون. No one will feel secure from the punish of Allah سبحانه وتعالى except the losers. There are ones who didn't think about the time they will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they worry about to fear Allah and not to fear Allah. Means they will do whatever they like in doing. After saying that, al-khawf min adhabillah fil akhirah. Muslim should always think about the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in akhirah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he explained a simple but it's a great hadith about, he said, the most abd who will receive the most light punishment in akhirah. You know, books of hadith explained, and also the Quran explained, how the punishment in the akhirah has levels. But now we will take only the light one, the easy way. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying that one who will receive the most light punishment in akhirah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will make him to wear something of fire in his legs, in his feet. So from that, it's gonna boil his head. It's easy, right? So everyone now believe that something's gonna be easy. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, what is gonna be in his feet is gonna boil his head. This is how it's gonna be the most light punishment in Jahannam. This is the first point of the hadith for today. The second one is al-raja. We're talking about al-khawf min Allah, to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But still, you must have a kind of hope, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he promised of forgiveness. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول My عباد do not spare of the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he called himself Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. So this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he promised. The hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes and say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He comes down in the last third of each night. And He looking for the mustaghfireen, looking for the raki'een, looking for the sajideen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will say, هَلْ مِن مُسْتَغْفِرٍ فَأَغْفِرُ لَهُ. Anyone seek, look for my forgiveness, I will forgive. Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the raja, the hope Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He forgive our sins. إن الله تعالى يبسط يده بالليل ليتوب مسيء النهار ويبسط يده بالنهار ليتوب مسيء الليل. الله سبحانه وتعالى will stretching his hands at night for the one who's sinning in the day. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى will stretching his hands in the day to forgive the sinning one in the night. What else you need after this deen, this Islam, this love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala He had for His abd? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith which is Qudsi, قال الله تعالى يا ابن آدم ابنك ما دعوتني ورجوتني غفرت لك ولا أبالي. Oh, the son of Adam, if you ask me, if you make the dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the forgiveness from the sins you do, Allah will forgive. But as we see what Al-Hasan al-Basri said, he said a great words. He said, إِنَّ قَوْمًا أَلْهَتْهُمْ أَمَانِيٌ مَغْفِرَةٌ حَتَّى خَرَجُوا مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَلَا حَسَنَةَ لَهُمْ. As Al-Hasan al-Basri explaining about this couple, about Ar-Raja, that the Muslims, they have always the hope of the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They always have that. Again, the Muslims, they always have only the hope, the raja, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will forgive them. But there is no any hasanat for them, because they only live, Allah is gonna forgive them. Come to salah, Allah is gonna forgive them. Come to Hajj and Umrah, Allah is going to forgive me. Come to Sawm, Allah is going to forgive me. So the Muslim only live for the hope. And this is something which is not allowed. As you have, I said, the hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala He forgive. Of course, we must have the khawf of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يَتَأَتَّى الْخَوْفِ لِعَبْدِ اللَّهِ unless he worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and obey. Last, شروط التوبة. توبة. توبة. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى about that. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He explained simple ayat about the Muslim. He should be with the sadiqeen, with ta'ibeen. At-tawbah has three conditions. One, al-iqla'u an al-ma'asi wa-dhunub. To be away, to stay away from any haram. Second, al-nadam. To have a sorry, regret from anything as muharram, as forbidden, you did before. The third, al-ikthar min al-a'mal as-salih. The Muslim should, after the tawbah, increase his a'mal as-salih. These three conditions about the tawbah. I will end the khutbah with mentioning something. It will come, inshallah, the end of this month, October 31st, which is the Halloween. We always mention that because some of the Muslims, the youth, the young ones, they share these things. But I will explain it in one hadith. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَتَأْمُرُنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَلَتَنْهَيُنَّ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ أَوْ لَيَصُبَّنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ الْعَذَابَ صَبْرًا. The hadith is clear. It's understood. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you always seek from the Muslim to stay in good, to stay in ta'ah, and stay away from the muharramat. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, either you stay in ma'roof, you stay in the right, and you move away from the munkar, from the thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he forbid, is small or big. Other way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will send his punishment over the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because they left al-amal al-salih, they left the guidelines of the Quran and sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the Halloween, it is something not from the guides of the Islam, it's not part of the Islam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, man tashabbaha biqawmin fahuwa minhum. Whoever imitating anyone and they trying to be like them, he's one of them. Of course, the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the youth, the kids, the male, the female, the old, the adult, everyone wants to stay on one path, as-sirat al-mustaqim. So we make sure we teach ourselves, teach our kids, teach our families, this is something as muharramat. We make sure we don't let our kids go in this line with the muharramat. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides us to this deen, the deen of Islam. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit 'ala al-haqq aqdamana. Allahumma ansurna 'ala al-qawm al-kafirin. Allahumma ansurna 'ala al-qawm al-kafirin. Allahumma a'izz al-islam wal muslimin. Allahumma a'izz al-islam wal muslimin. Allahumma ishfi amradana. Allahumma ishfi amradana warham amwatana. Warham amwatana wahfaz buyutana wahfaz awladana واحفظ أزواجنا واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا من كل خير. اللهم اجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم وأقوم إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم.